What's going on, guys? It's New York Prepper here. In this video, I just want to do a quick review of a buttstock cartridge carrier that I recently picked up for my 416 Ruger dangerous game rifle, okay? And you guys have seen me do videos with that gun before. It's a Ruger guide gun chambered in 416 Ruger. And I wanted to get a buttstock cartridge carrier, but, you know, a lot of the cheap nylon ones that you can get, they fall apart and they start to get loose and they don't hold the cartridge as well. After a while, the loops start to get loose, you know. So I said, let me invest a little bit of money and get something high quality that's going to last me a while, and, you know, something that's reliable that I can use on a dangerous game hunt. And this is the one that I got. This one is made by Mason Leather out of Texas. And I'll put a link in the description box down below the video. And this is a 100% custom leather buttstock cartridge carrier. It's pretty simple design. I had them stamp the American flag on here. I had them do this nice brown color, this vintage brown tan color on the leather. And the leather's quite thick. I forget what thickness they use. I think it's an 8-ounce leather. And it's a pretty simple design. They just have some holes punched on the bottom here, and you just take the paracord that they give you and you just tie it along the bottom like a shoelace, and you have this little loop on the back to go over the recoil pad, okay? And this will give me 5 extra rounds of 416 Ruger, and this is what I plan to carry with me when I go on a future Alaskan brown bear hunt or an African Cape buffalo hunt someday soon. So I highly recommend you guys get this. Look at this beautiful tanning work that they did on this cartridge carrier. Look at that beautiful leather. Just absolutely gorgeous leather work that they did here. And I love that American flag that they stamped on here. Gorgeous, gorgeous leather, guys. You can pick different colors. And the leather's already kind of broken in. Actually, it has a nice soft feel to it. It's not very stiff or anything. You can see it's pretty broken in. It's not like, you know, it's not noisy. You know, you can hear it's not like really loud or anything. It's kind of soft already. And look at how thick the leather they use on these loops here. These loops have a really thick leather. Look at that, guys. This is going to last a while for a lot of hunts in some difficult terrain. And you know, this is the 416 Ruger cartridge, and you guys have probably seen me do a lot of penetration tests with this gun. The 416 Ruger is a dangerous game cartridge for safari hunting and dangerous game bears, big bears, Cape buffalo, elephant. This could take an elephant down with one shot. That's how powerful it is. Not that I would ever want to hunt an elephant, me personally. More interested in Cape buffalo and Alaskan brown bear, just because I think they're the most challenging, dangerous game you can hunt. But it's a 400 grain bullet here, and it travels at 2,400 feet per second, and it generates between 5,000 and 5,500 foot-pounds of muzzle energy. Basically double the energy of a 30-06, okay, with hot loads. So it's a very powerful cartridge. It shoots this massive 400 grain bullet, which has exceptional sectional density and penetration characteristics. I shot this through a 2-foot white oak piece of firewood. That's how powerful these cartridges are. So I got this cartridge carrier for the buttstock. I know a lot of guys that hunt dangerous game in Africa and in Alaska, they like to have those colors, the culling belts. They like to have the culling belts, which are just basically literally a leather belt that has cartridge loops sewn into it or stitched into it. And I don't like those because... you know, if you have clothing on, you know, those loops can get covered up with clothing, or depending on what position you're in, it may be hard to get the ammo out of the loops. But if you have it on your buttstock, it's already in your hands. All you got to do is just pop it right out and reload. And it's always important when you're hunting dangerous game to have spare reloads on you. All right, you're not hunting deer, okay? You're hunting an animal that can kill you. And you want to make sure that you have at least one full reload available. And my Ruger guide gun can hold 4 416 Ruger cartridges. So here I have 5. So if I top off my rifle when I'm hunting, I have 4. And then this cartridge carrier gives me a full recharge of my rifle, another 4 plus an extra 1, okay? So if I can't bring down a dangerous game animal with, you know, 9 rounds of 416 Ruger, then we need a bazooka. But, you know, you always want to have spare reloads on hand when you're hunting dangerous game, because, you know, when that adrenaline starts to flow, you may miss your shots. You know, if you got an animal that's charging at you, or it's running in a weird angle and there's brush, you know, you may miss your shot. So you always want to have spares on hand, and you want them to be quickly accessible. And I know a lot of guys like the culling belts because they're right on your belt and you can pull the ammo out, but I'd rather just have it right on the buttstock so I know that it's always there. And as long as I'm holding the rifle in my hand, I have some spare ammo and I can just pop these out. And when you order this from Mason Leather, all you got to do is just tell them what cartridge the carrier is for, and they'll make it custom for your cartridge so the loops are nice and tight. All right, so as you can see, they fit nice and snug, and obviously these are new, so I'm sure after a while they'll loosen up a little bit. You can see they're nice and snug, and it takes a good amount of pressure to get them out, so it holds it nice and tight, but it's not too tight to where you can't, you know, pull them out when you need them, especially if you got a wounded bear or wounded Cape buffalo and it wants to kill you. You know, you want to be able to get these out quick, but you also don't want them to fall out on the ground when you're moving through the brush. So you want it to be just snug enough to where you can pop these out, okay, and reload, but you don't want them to be too loose where they're going to fall out, okay? And you know, so I just wanted to share this with you guys. I know I have some people who watch me that are into big game hunting and dangerous game hunting. So I just wanted to recommend this great small business to you guys, Mason Leather. Check them out. They don't just make cartridge carriers for your buttstocks. They make all kinds of custom leather, you know, all kinds of different leather craft. So they make some beautiful stuff. So I highly recommend you guys check them out. Absolutely gorgeous leather work here. And they didn't pay me or anything to do this video. I just bought this for myself, and I wanted to just review a good product to you guys. And one last thing I will say is that you know, when you have your reloads here, especially if you're hunting dangerous game, you want to make sure that you have a mixture of different bullets. So what I have here is I have 3 solids and 2 expanders, okay? You always want to make sure you have more solids than you have expanders, because the expanders are your offensive weapon. The expanders are the ones that are going to do the most damage, and those are the ones that you use for your first initial shot. But your solids are the ones that are going to be your defensive rounds that you're going to use to, you know, flatten any kind of dangerous animal that's trying to kill you. Okay, so here I just have 3 Hornady Dangerous Game solids, 400 grain. And then I have 2 400 grain TSX bullets. And these TSX bullets are absolutely monstrous penetrators. And these solids are just basically armor piercing. I had these are the solids that I used to shoot through 26 2x10 joists, or 26 2x10 framing lumber. And I'll attach a video up above of that test that I did. so you guys can see it. And I'll also attach a video of me shooting these rounds through a 2-foot diameter oak log, fresh white oak. So check out Mason Leather, guys, and hopefully I'll be able to get you guys some dangerous game hunting videos in the future when I go on some real dangerous game hunts. For now, I'm just going to be hunting black bear here in the east, but I am trying to get out west and get to Alaska and try to get a brown bear hunt at some point in the near future. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching. Take care. God bless. And don't forget the 3 P's: prepare, practice, and persevere.